So we're still here with the beautiful Lacey Jane for this special Valentine's Day edition of Kush and Konvo. So to continue the conversation, you brushed on it a little earlier in the dialogue that there are a lot of misconceptions about, you know, women in the industry and having those misconceptions tonight. So, having to deal with a lot of those misconceptions, like how do you, you know, negate them? You don't, you know, you're not that open sexually as far as people would say maybe you would do threesomes, you date women, you know, they just have those thoughts of strippers or women who, you know, maybe a video vixen or do urban modeling, that they must go for anything. They pose.
Yeah, they think that entertainers are like actual freaks. Like that we're just the most freakiest girl. I know bitches who are nurses who are 10 times freakier than me.
Exactly.
They definitely misconcept like a lot of things, not just that. You know, I feel like, you know, everything is, you know, not what it is. Like, I'm still like a normal person. I still have feelings and, you know, I'm not just like all about, you know, money. Like I like a lot of things more than money, you know, believe it or not. So I think a lot of things are misconcepted with our dancers in the entertainment world.
So how do you help kind of, like, how do you block that, or how do you kind of help negate it? Like, how do you kind of help shut it down? So that it can kind of stop.
Well, I kind of give off the like impression that I am afraid. Like, that's how I get money.
Okay.
Like, I have to act like, you know, I'm just always so sexy and, you know, just, you know, like perfect and just always ready to get some dick or something. Like, and I guess that's just, I mean, that's how I get money, like on a Snapchat or whatever, you know, or Instagram. I just gotta like be sexy and stuff all the time, and I'm really not a sexy person in general. Like, I mean, I look sexy, but I'm not like, you know, just like, I'm not a big freak like that, so.
Right, so, and not having that type of openness, like, how far do you go sexually? Like, what would you consider, like, your freak number? Would you, are you just, like, regular missionary sex, or do you get a little?
I mean, it just depends on, I mean, who I'm with, or, you know, what time of day it is.
Like, okay.
Like, I hate when they be trying to fuck when I'm tired. Like, let me sleep, you know? Like, I'm not gonna be as freaky as I can be if I'm tired, you know?
Okay.
Like,
okay.
So, like, if it's like 6 in the morning, then no, I'm not gonna be that freaky, you know? But if it's like, you know, more like 2, then yeah, you know? Okay. So it just really depends how much alcohol I've had, how long I've been without sex. Yeah, it's always different.
Lights on or off?
I like lights on. I just think I look better in the light. I do, like, when the lights came out of Follies, I'm like, see, I'm still good. I'm not ugly like the rest of these bitches when they go in the locker room and you're like,
who is that?
Yeah, we're talking to all right. Like, you had all that back acne for real. Like, you can't even see it out there, you know?
So, you do music or no music?
No music.
Yeah,
I mean, I'll take music. I don't want to give a fuck, but I don't like music.
Okay.
Like, no, it's not that serious.
Okay. Are you a talker?
No, not at all. I don't talk at all. I will, like, be silent. I mean, of course, you moan and stuff like that. But
if they're talking to you,
they're like, say my name or, and I just don't say nothing. I don't be like yes or no or say their name at all. I just be quiet. Like, I don't say shit. Like, I just let them talk their shit.
That's like the weirdest flight that's had said. What type of things are you like propositioned with in your DM? Now that people are so, it's so easy to access everybody. You can just send them a message and whether you read it or don't, or respond or don't, like, I'm sure you come across some wild.
Most people ask me how much for sex. I guess I at least look like a prostitute. But I guess sometimes I don't really blame them because, I mean, I did put myself out there like that, and I don't blame them. Like, if I seen a bad bitch, I'd probably ask how much too, you know, whether she was a stripper or not. But yeah, sometimes I put what I get in my DMs on my Snapchat, screenshot it, and like blur their name out or whatever, because it's so hilarious, and I laugh at it so much that I know my followers will laugh at it too, and they do. I mean, they just like, they're like, they, people ask me like how much for my used panties. They asked me, I used to send,
oh my God,
I used to send so many feet pictures, and they'd be like, I know, I need the soles of your feet. And I'm like, okay, cool. They're like, oh, I need them to be dirty. And I'm like, oh, we're not supposed to go walk outside real fast? I mean, like, that's just some of it. You don't even know. I get it all.
I get crazy shit. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. It's pretty hilarious.
Are you currently single?
Yes, I am. And I don't want to change that.
Okay.
I'm not gonna change that. I'm focused on me.
Okay.
And I'm not focused on no guy and love and all that. I'm trying to build, you know, my empire and learn myself and experience and travel. And I don't want to be heartbroken and be fucking the same dude and other bitches and us be like in competition. Like, no, ain't no competition, bitch.
I don't know, that's,
so yes, I'm single,
good.
And I'm happily single. I don't want to be in a relationship.
That's good. That's good. I totally understand that. Have you ever dated anyone in the industry?
No, I have not. Mm-mm. I mean, of course, I've had like relationships, but it's not like dating. Like, what do you call it? Like, not owning somebody, but claiming.
Okay.
No, so I've never claimed nobody.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Are you against dating in the industry? Do you like kind of stay away from that? Do you know how we can?
Yeah, I just, you know, I'm just not interested in that. Like, I'm not interested in that, like, drama there. Like, you know, I think I'm better than that. You know, to be like in drama with, you know, because I mean, that's what rappers and athletes do. I mean, they do what they want to do, and who am I to say any different? They can do any different. So I let them do them.
Okay. And you kind of touched on earlier that you're really chill. Like, so outside of your, you know, the type of career that you have, you're kind of opposite from that. You're like really laid back.
Oh yeah, I'm a huge pothead. I'm not really friendly.
Okay.
When people come up to me and say, hey, then I'll become a smile. But other than that, I, you know, I'm just really chill. I want to eat and just smoke and travel and just be around friends and family. And really what matters in life, like, you know, just learning and experiencing and, like I said, traveling.
Is it new to you to kind of really still be this figure? I mean, because as your brand grows and your popularity grows, people will approach you in the more than one picture.
People treat me like way more than I am. Like, they make me feel famous. Like, they make me feel like I'm somebody. For me, I'm just a country girl who likes to chill and, you know, like, just really live life. I mean, I really live life every day. I wake up and like, what do I want to do today? You know, I don't really think about what music video can I get in a day, or you know, what rapper can I, you know, get involved with today? I don't, none of that. Like, you know, I'm just, I'd rather just be around family and friends and have a good time. And,
yeah. I know you said that you like to shoot guns. What's your favorite gun?
Probably like a baby nine.
A baby nine?
Yeah, I mean, okay. I shot AKs and ARs, but they're not fun. I mean, they're fun, but like, I like to play around.
Okay.
And there you gotta be like all serious and shit with it. But I used to actually be like shoot skeet. I don't know if anybody knows what that means, but it's like they pull like a thing and it shoots up and you know, shoot it. And I shoot like, I was really good at
that's with like as a rifle
shotgun.
And you said you would go hunting and things like
I don't kill animals. I'm a big animal lover, but my family are huge hunters, yes. And they actually eat like tons of meat, and I don't really eat that much meat, and so we're a lot different, but I still love guns.
So you're still
I just don't want to shoot people and kill or shoot things and kill them.
Right. So you said you like four-wheelers, so you're just like really adventurous.
I used to ride four-wheeler. Like, I could have raced if I wanted to. My brother, he's really big into it, and flat tracks and jumps and stuff, so I was like always following his lead. Like, anything he was interested in, I was, and I was really good at riding four-wheelers. it's kind of like free when you're on a floater, just like when you're on a boat or a jet ski and you're feeling free and you have control, and it's pretty amazing. It's a high, you know.
And speaking of high, that you're a pot enthusiast. What's your favorite strain?
I don't have a favorite strain, but I do. I travel all over the world this movie. I just got back from Amsterdam.
How was it?
Oh, well, of all the places, Amsterdam was the best.
Okay.
It was just so more free there. I've been to Colorado, I've been to Toronto and LA and different places to smoke weed. You know, Amsterdam was, it was amazing.
So your favorite way to ingest the smoking, you do edibles?
I do edibles, but I don't, dabs.
Okay.
I don't do dabs. It's kind of crackheadish to me. And I get so high anyway. I'm like, how high can I fucking get?
My best friend says that the way you have to consume it, she's the same. She's like, that's
it's
like
Denver. They wouldn't let me smoke a blunt in the area we're in, but we could dab. And I'm like,
what's the difference?
Like if we're doing it outside, but I'm kind of over blunts now. I don't really smoke much but blunts. I do the raw papers and the raw cones. It's just, you know, it's healthier or whatever. So I do it all different ways. I guess I just got a weed pen with me now because I just got in the car, so I don't want to smoke blunts in it yet. So I got me a little pen. And, so yeah.
Okay. So what's next for Lacey J? Like, what can we? I know we can catch you at Follies.
Yeah.
But you just launched the website.
I did. LaceyJ.net. I just launched it on Christmas, and you know, there I used to be like on Cam Soda and Connect Pal and all these different things. So I put all my content in one area, and you can subscribe on there and become a member and get exclusive content, pictures, you know, videos, and from there and on there also you can see all the music videos I did, and some pictures and a little bit about me and how to contact me. And so I just wanted to, you know, one place that I could, because I was selling my pictures and videos on Connect Pal, and they were getting a little percentage of it, which is fine, but now I have my own website, so I get all of it. So definitely check that out, and you know, I really don't know what's next, and that's the fun of it, you know, and because I really can do anything I ever put my mind to, and that's why I just really like focus on myself right now and traveling, because I experience so much different stuff all the time. Like, oh, I think I like to do this instead or that instead. I like this food instead. Or, you know, just different things have made me who I am right now, just by traveling and, you know, just learning and focusing on myself. So who knows what's next, really? Like, I mean, I might turn around and become a damn priest. No, I'm kidding.
We'll go see Reverend Dr. Lacey J.
All around, entertainer, like, I do it all. But definitely stay tuned and see what's next.
Well, we're definitely going to keep up. We appreciate you coming through to the show today. Happy Valentine's Day. And you guys, keep up with Lacey J, man. She's just launched her site, LaceyJ.net.
Yes.
Where can they follow you on social media?
All my social media is The Real Lacey J, T-H-A, Real Lacey J. You definitely want to follow me.
She's very entertaining. Trust me. Thank you guys for tuning in. Season 2, Kush and Konvo, live in Atlanta. With pots and pans, come and Quavo ride a tulip. Run with that set, call me boobies. When I'm on stage, show me boobies. Ice on my neck on the coolest. How about the suicide with the ooze? I pull up, I hop out with all of the drugs and the good luck. I'm cooking, I'm whipping.